Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Chemistry Unplugged. Today we will discuss about color and electronic spectra of coordination complexes. It is part 1. In this video we will discuss about how the color originates, what are the selection rule to determine the transition is feasible or not, then intensity of color complexes, and we will take DG transition and charge transfer transition. In charge transfer transition, we will discuss four type of CT transitions. First is ligand metal, then metal ligand, intravalence and intra ligand transition. So you can follow me on Unacademy using my name or this link. Then please subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon for future notification. So let's start the video. First is how color originate in coordination complexes. So color is due to the transition of electron from ground energy state to excited energy state. When electron excites from ground energy level to excited energy level, it absorbs some amount of energy. And in case of coordination complexes, this energy lies in visible range. So you will get a color complex. This energy gap is simply equal to H nu, or you can write it like HC upon lambda or HC nu bar, where nu bar is the wave number and nu is the frequency, lambda is wavelength. So you can determine different energy values in different terms using these formulas. Okay, next thing is how we can determine the color of the complexes. So color is determined using artist color wheel. What artist color wheel says that colors of white color is consist of seven colors. White color is consist of seven color. It is sum of vivgyor. Vivgyor means violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. Okay, so according to this wheel, if you want to find out a color of a complex, you will have to simply remember this, that color of absorbed and transmitted light are complementary to each other. What is its means? Means suppose a complex is absorbing this violet color, this one is absorbed, then you will get a transmitted light of yellow color, or you can see a yellow color complex. The color of complex will be yellow, means these two color are complementary to each other, these two are complementary to each other, and these two are complementary to each other. So if a complex is absorbing in this region, you will get a complex of yellow region, or a complex is absorbing a red color, then you will get a complex of green color. And if a complex is absorbing blue color, this color is absorbed, then orange color complex you will get. Okay, so I have a complex, suppose TiH2O whole 6 3 plus, a complex of titanium. This complex is of purple color. This complex is of purple color. Means purple is in between violet and red. Means it is absorbing in range of yellow green. Okay. And suppose I have a complex of copper. This complex is of blue color. Color of complex is blue. Means it is absorbing in the range of orange. It is absorbing a light of orange color, or you can say the light, the wavelength of light absorbed is of orange range, then you will get a complex of blue color. Next example, I have a nickel complex, and this complex is of green color. Means a light of red color is absorbed. Okay, and if all the colors are absorbed by a species, then you will get black color, or if all the colors are transmitted, you will get white color, because when all color are transmitted, these seven colors sum up to give you white color. Okay, so this is the concept of artist color wheel. Then next we move to a complex of titanium, which is of purple color. We have seen this. So how the color transition or electronic transition takes place in the coordination complexes? Suppose I have a complex of titanium. So titanium is 22. Okay, its atomic number is 22. Means it has 4s2d2. And because it is in Ti plus 3 state, so titanium plus 3 will have d1. Okay, only one electron in. So if I draw it like this, because it is an octahedral complex, so T2G will be of lower energy and Eg will be of higher energy. So only one electron, so it will be in the T2G shell. So when I provide energy to this complex, this electron will absorb energy and move from T2G to Eg. So it will become like this. Okay, after absorbing of certain amount of energy, this electron will move in the Eg. So I will get a peak like this, and this peak belongs to 20300 inverse value. This graph is in between absorbance and wave number, and this graph gives me a peak for this complex of titanium, and the peak value is equal to 20,300 centimeter inverse. So from this value, I can determine the value of crystal field splitting energy, because the energy gap between T2G and Eg is given by delta naught, and the transition energy also gives me this value. So this energy of absorption can give me a value of delta naught, and this is equal to 20,300 centimeter inverse. So in this case, del naught is equal to 20,300 centimeter inverse in case of this transition, this complex. So if I want to represent this energy in terms of kilojoule per mole, then I can change it, because 1 kilojoule per mole is equal to 83.7 centimeter inverse. So if I divide this value by this, then I will get a value of 243 kilojoule per mole. Okay, this value is equal to this energy. Okay, I can represent it in centimeter inverse or in kilojoule per mole inverse. So this is the crystal field splitting energy calculation, but I can use this transition value equal to crystal field splitting energy only in case of one electron in D shell. I cannot apply it for more than one electrons, because in that case I have to consider various things like electron-electron interaction and various things. We will discuss them later. How we can determine the crystal field splitting energy in case of multi-electron system during the electronic transition. We will also discuss numericals based on them. So this is a simple example. Then we move to next thing, type of transition. So first type is DD transition. DD transition is simple, that from one D shell to another D shell, T2G to Eg transition, or Eg to T2G in case of tetrahedral complexes. So this is a simple DD transition. Next is charge transfer transition. Charge transfer transitions are very different. Charge transfer means one electron is excited or transferred from one orbital of one species to orbital of another species. Means I am transferring electron from an orbital of metal to ligand or ligand to metal. So these are different. We will take them in detail a little bit later. First, we will take some examples of DD transitions. Okay, and these two electronic transitions are only for coordination complexes. In case of organic compounds, we have seen different type of transition like sigma sigma star, n pi n to pi star, n to sigma star, pi to pi star. These all transitions were in case of organic compounds, in case we have seen them in UV spectroscopy. But these two transitions are specifically for coordination complexes. So DD transition and trans-transfer transitions are for coordination complexes. Next thing is, why different complexes show different colors? Suppose I have a complex like this, TiCl 6-3- and TiH2O. In both the cases, I have only one electron in D shell. It also has D1 and it also consists of D1, but they are of different colors. Reason is this, because in case of TiCl6, the crystal field splitting is less because H2O is a strong field ligand as compared to chlorine. Okay, so the energy gap between Eg and T2G is small as compared to this one. The energy gap in this case is small as compared to this one. So when energy gap is higher, the energy of absorption will be higher and wavelength will be low. So the energy gap is governed by the ligands attached with metals. Okay, and how much they can cause splitting of these energy levels. So this is about DD transition. So we have seen the how the color originates. Then next thing is, if all the transitions are allowed or not, then to determine the allowedness of a transition, we have to consider some selection rule. So first selection rule is Laporte selection rule. Laporte selection rule says that del L value should be equal to plus minus 1, and then this transition is allowed. G to U and or U to G transitions are allowed, then del L value equal to 0 is forbidden transition. Means if change in azimuthal quantum number is plus minus 1, then transitions are allowed. Means S to P, okay, P to D or P to S, D to P, these transitions are allowed. But if a transition is from P to P, when there is no change in the L value, then these transitions are forbidden. Similarly, if G to G transition, this is also forbidden. U to U transitions are also forbidden. G to U or U to G transitions are allowed. So in case of DD transition, the transition is from T to G to EG orbital. Okay, and both of them belongs to B. B means both of them have same L value, that is 2. Means change in L value during the transition is 0. Okay, and this transition is also from G to G, grad to grad. So according to Laporte selection rule, D to D transition of this type in octahedral complexes should be forbidden. These are not allowed. So according to Laporte selection rule, such type of transition are not allowed. But there are some relaxation in Laporte selection rule for octahedral and tetrahedral complexes. In case of these complexes, there are some spin orbital mixing which can causes the relaxation in Laporte selection rule. And in case of tetrahedral complexes, the complexes are formed by some mixing of p and d orbitals. So there is some p d orbital. Orbitals are bonding and non-bonding orbitals are formed by some pd mixing. So because of pd mixing, Laporte selection rule is partly allowed for tetrahedral complexes. For tetrahedral complexes, these transition dd transitions are partly allowed, or you can say that there is some relaxation in case of these. So we will place them in the category of partly allowed transitions. Next thing is, next selection rule is spin selection rule. According to this rule, delta S value should be equal to 0. Means there should not be change in S value during the transition. Okay, so what is its means? That if total spin quantum number is suppose S1 and it is equal to suppose 1 before the transition, so after the transition total S value should be equal to 1. In that case del S will become 0 and such type of transitions are allowed. Suppose I have a octahedral complex in which d orbital has 2 electrons. Okay, so in T2G, and this is EG, so in T2G I have 2 electrons here, and after the electronic transition 1 electron from T2G will move to EG. So I can write it like this. So before transition, the sum of spin quantum number to capital S is equal to plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. So it is equal to 1. And after transition, it is also equal to 1. So in this case, del S value is 0. Okay. And when you are determining the S value, you will have to consider high spin and low spin complexes. Consider their crystal field splitting on the basis of a spectrochemical series. So always remember these things while determining the S value. Second thing is, suppose I have a situation like this. Suppose I have a situation like this. Okay, this is the situation before electronic transition. And now I am exciting one electron from this T2G level to EG. So in that case, electron will move from T2G to EG. So when we are doing such type of transition, because EG is fully filled, in that case the spin of this electron will change. If this orbital is empty, then it will move from here to here, simply its spin will remain same. But if this orbital is already filled, already half filled, then in that case after transition the spin of this electron will change. It will become downward like this. Okay. And in T2G situation is this. So spin direction will change only in that case when you have partly filled orbitals. Otherwise it will remain same. Okay. So remember these things. So in case of DD transition, two rules are there. First is Laporte rule and second is spin selection rule. So we will classify complexes on the basis of their allowedness in Laporte selection rule and spin selection rule. So first we will take some more example of DD transition. Suppose I have a complex of cobalt. So next we have a complex of cobalt. It is COCl4 2-. COCl4 means it is a tetrahedral complex because it has 4 ligands. Okay, and cobalt is in plus 2 state, means d7 electrons. So in case of tetrahedral complexes, this is T2 and it is E. So because in case of tetrahedral complexes, this energy gap is not so much high, so electron can be filled like this in the form of high spin. Okay, because energy gap is not so much high, so they will be filled like this. So this is the situation before transition. After electronic transition, one electron from E will move in the T2. So the S value, this is S1, suppose it is plus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, it is equal to 3 by 2. Then after transition, this is after absorbance of energy, so S2 is equal to plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, then plus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, it is 3 by 2. So the change in S value is equal to 0. So it is following spin selection rule, it is allowed. Okay. Second thing is, although del L value is 0 in this case, but because it is a tetrahedral complex, so it is Laporte partly allowed. If it is a octahedral complex, then in that case it will be Laporte forbidden. But because it is tetrahedral, it is Laporte partly allowed. Okay, so it is spin allowed and Laporte partly allowed. Next type of transitions are charge transfer transitions. So charge transfer transitions are transfer of electron from orbital of one species to orbital of other species. Suppose I have a complex MnO4-. So manganese is 25. So it is 4s2 3d5. Okay, and it is in Mn7+ state means it has 0 electron in D shell. Means there is no electron for D to D transition. So in that case, transitions or the color of complex may be due to transfer of electron from ligands or other species. We know that KMnO4 is dark purple in color. So what is the reason of its color? Because electrons are transferred from O to Mn. Okay. So we have oxygen here, and oxygen is in 2- state. 2- state means it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 state. Okay, means electrons from 2p6 are transferred from, electrons from 2p6 are transferred to d0. So suppose this is o2-, it is in lower in energy, so these are p orbitals. Okay, so electrons from these p orbitals are transferred to 3d0 shell of Mn+7. They suppose this electron is transferred from here to here. This is 2p6 and they are transferred from here to here. So in this case, L value, change in L value is equal to 1+1. P has L value 1 and D is 2. So change in L value is +1. Next thing is, what is the change in S value? Initially, S was 0 when there was no transition. S was total S. +1, +1/2, -1/2, +1/2, -1/2, +1/2, -1/2. So total S value was 0 before transition. After transition, the situation is like this. So total L value is again 0. So the change in S value is equal to 0. So this type of transition is Laporte allowed as well as spin allowed. So both type of allowed transition are the charge transfer transitions. Example of such type of transitions are CrO4-, Cr2O7-2. We will take them in detail. Okay, so what are the different type of transfer transition? We will take them in detail. So first we will determine the intensity of various coordination complexes on the basis of their Laporte and spin allowedness. So here we have a table In table, we have placed Laporte selection rule, spin selection rule, type of spectra, absorbance, and we will take their example. So, if a transition is Laporte allowed, Laporte allowed means del L value is equal to 0 and G to U transition or U to G transitions are allowed, G to G, U to U are forbidden. Then spin selection rule means del S is equal to 0 and it is also allowed. So such type of transitions are found in charge transfer transitions. We have seen this, that in case of charge transfer transition, both the things are allowed. So in that case, the absorbance value is greater than 10 to the power 4 or 10,000 L mole inverse centimeter inverse. Okay, so examples of such type of transitions are MnO 4 minus CrO 4 2 minus Cr2O 7 2 minus CrO 3. Okay, such type of transition, all the charge transfer transition will fall in this category. Next type is, suppose we have Laporte partly allowed. So Laporte partly allowed were the case of tetrahedral complexes where we have seen PD mixing, and due to some PD mixing, the transition in tetrahedral complexes were partly Laporte allowed. Okay. Then suppose spin selection rule says that they are allowed. So such type of transitions are due to DD transition. Okay, and in that case category, the absorbance will decrease because one of them is partly allowed, other one is allowed, but one of them is partly allowed. So they have absorbance from 800 to 1000. So example of such type of transition are tetrahedral complexes of cobalt COCl4 2 minus and COBr4 2 minus. Next type is when Laporte forbidden. Okay, Laporte forbidden is the case of again octahedral complexes. Okay, and suppose they are spin allowed. Transition is DD transition and absorbance will again decrease and it is nearly 100. And this is the category of octahedral complexes of titanium TiH2⁬ plus 3. Then vanadium complex, nickel and copper complex is also of this category CuH2⁬ 3 plus. Then next type is Laporte partly allowed. Again the case of tetrahedral complexes. But this time they are spin forbidden. Means change in del S or change in spin value is not equal to 0. This is also DD. And because one of them is partly allowed and other one is forbidden, so the absorbance will again decrease. It is 8 to 10. And example are MnCl4 2 minus and MnBr4 2 minus. Then last category is where both are forbidden. This one is forbidden as well as this one is also forbidden. So forbidden is the case of octahedral complex, and because and spin change is also not following the spin selection rule, so it is also forbidden DD transition, and this absorbance is very small, 0.1. Example is the manganese complex, octahedral complex, this one MnH2⁬ 2 plus, and iron complex. Okay, so this is the table for the absorbance of different complexes. So always remember this, that if both the type of selection rule are allowed, then this is the category of charge transfer transition. Okay, generally it is the case for charge transfer transition, because in case of DD transition, it Laporte selection rule is only partly allowed for tetrahedral complexes. For octahedral complexes, it is forbidden. Okay, next we can determine intensity of the complexes on the basis of allowedness of the selection rule. If both are allowed, then intensity or absorbance is high. If one of them is partly allowed, intensity will decrease. Then intensity will again decrease in case one is forbidden, other one is allowed. Then again decrease when one is partly allowed, other one is forbidden, and least for the when both are forbidden. So this is the order of their intensity. Next, I will take some examples. Suppose I have a complex of TiCl4 2 minus, TiCl6 2 minus. Okay, so titanium is 22, and in this case it is Ti plus 4. Okay, so 22 means 4s2 3d2, and when it is in plus 4 oxidation state, then d orbital has 0 electrons. So in case of 0 electrons means it is not dd transition. Electrons are excited from Cl to Ti. So it is the case of charge transfer transition. So Cl in minus 1 state has 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 6, 3s2, 3p, 6 electrons. Okay, because it is in Cl minus state. So 3p, 6 electrons. So electrons are excited from 3p6 to d0. So it is the case of trans transfer transition. It is Laporte allowed because change in L value is equal to plus 1. And spin allowedness can be checked using this. Suppose before the transition, these are the p orbitals of Cl, suppose, and it is fully filled. So the total S value is 0. And electrons are excited from S to D0 of titanium plus 4. One electron from P will move to D0. So it has electron like this. So S value is again 0. So this is the situation when del S is equal to 0. Therefore, this complex is charge transfer transition in which both the selection rule allow the transition. So it has very high intensity. Next, we take an example of suppose COH2O whole 6 2 plus and MnNH3 whole 6 plus 2. We have two complexes and we want to find out their intensity. So first we will take the complex of cobalt. So cobalt is in plus 2 state. So when it is in plus 2 state, it has d7 electrons. D7 electrons means, so Mn in cobalt plus 2, we have 7 electrons in d shell. Okay, and H2O is comparatively weak ligand than ammonia, and it will forms high spin complexes. So we have a situation like this. So we have 7 electrons because the splitting is not so much high, so we have to form high spin complex. So this is the situation before transition. After absorbance of energy or the transition, the situation will be like this. So one electron from here will move to here. So S value before the transition was, this one is 0, for this one is 0, then it S value is 3 by 2. and after transition it is also 3 by 2. So this type of transition is spin allowed but Laporte forbidden, because it is an octahedral complex and transition from D to D there is no change in L value, so this is Laporte forbidden. Again we have another octahedral complex, so it is also Laporte forbidden. We have to check whether it is spin allowed or not. So it is Mn plus 2, means we have 5 electrons in D shell. So before transition this will be the situation, because ammonia is a stronger field ligand, so it will cause more splitting, so we have low spin complex. So 5 electrons in T2G and no electron in EG. So the spin of this complex is before transition it is 1 by 2. After transition one of the electron from this T2G will move to EG, okay, but its spin direction will remain same after the transition, so it will remain in minus 1 by 2 state. So the total spin is again 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, plus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2, 0, then plus 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2. The change in S value is equal to 0. So this transition or this complex is following Laporte forbidden and spin allowed transition. So both the complexes have same selection rule, it means they have almost same intensity, so we cannot differentiate their intensity on the basis of deselection rule. They have almost same intensity. Then next is charge transfer transition. We have studied about charge transfer transition. Next we move on to the type of charge transfer transition. So first type is ligand metal charge transfer transition. As the name denotes, transfer of charge from ligand to metal. So there is transfer of electron from ligand to metal. We have seen this type of transition in previous slides, in which we have taken the example of MnO4-. So the electrons were transferred from O2- to Mn plus 7. Electron from p6 orbital move to d0 orbital. It is also denoted by LMCT. What are the conditions for this type of transition? First is metal should be in high oxidation state. Metal should have a high oxidation state. High oxidation state means electron deficient. When it is electron deficient, it is ready to accept electron from the ligands. So first condition is metals should be in high oxidation state. Second is ligand should be electron rich. If they have sufficient electron, then they are able to provide electron to the metals. Third is empty d orbitals of metal. Empty d orbitals of metal. Metals should have empty d orbitals to accept electrons. So example of such type of transition is MnO4- CrO4 2- Cr2O7 2- Cr3 TiCl6 2- etc. So these are the examples of charge ligand metal charge transfer transition. Suppose I am taking example in which, so transition is from p orbital to suppose 3d0, and one transition is from p to 4d0, and next one is suppose p to 5d0. So the energy gap is highest between this P to 5d0 is suppose this much, then P to 4d0 is suppose this much, and P2 3D naught is the smallest energy difference. Okay, so for such type of transition, this energy gap is the smallest and this one is high. Suppose this one is observed if in the colored region, means in the visible region, the wavelength is high for this, and for this the wavelength should be low, because energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. So when energy gap is high, then wavelength will be low. So if it is in the visible range, then this type of transition can be in the UV range, because for the UV range the wavelength is low, energy gap is high, wavelength will be low. So you can differentiate complex on the basis of their d orbitals, from p orbitals to which d orbital transition is taken place. On the basis of this, you can differentiate them. So energy gap is an important criteria from which you can determine the wavelength. The next type is metal ligand charge transfer transition. So metal to ligand transition of electron means electrons are excited from d orbitals of metal to the ligand. So the condition for such type of transition is, first is metal should be in low oxidation state. Low oxidation state. If it has low oxidation state, means it has sufficient number of electron to provide to the ligand. Second condition is ligand should have vacant orbitals. Ligands should have vacant orbitals in which they can accept electrons. So example of such type of transitions, or the ligands of such type of transition, are CO, phenanthrene and CN-. The ligands which are pi acceptors are also the example of such type of transition. Bipyridine. These all are example of metal ligand charge transfer transition. MLCT. Then next type is intervalence charge transfer transition. Intervalence means metal to metal, metal to metal transition of electrons. Means suppose one metal is in the low oxidation state and other one is in the higher oxidation state. So it can provide, the low oxidation state metal can provide electron to the higher oxidation state metal. So this type of transition is example of intervalence charge transfer transition. For example, we have a complex of iron. So in this complex, this iron is in +3 oxidation state and this one is in the +2 oxidation state. So this iron can provide electron to this one. Fe+2 can provide electron to Fe+3. And this type of transition is an example of intervalence charge transfer transition. So because of this transition, this complex is of Prussian blue color. Next example is PB3O4. PB3O4 is 2PbO dot PbO2. So this lead is in +2 state and this one is in +4 state. So electrons are excited from this oxidation state to this one. So because of this, it is red in color. Next type, or the last type, is intra ligand charge transfer transition. Intra means within the ligand. So ligand to ligand excitation or the transfer of electron falls in the category of intra ligand charge transfer transition. So such type of complex show the transition due to pi to pi star, sigma to sigma star and n to pi star and N2 sigma star transition. These transitions are due to chromophoric character of these ligands and they can be of 4 different types. I will finish this video here. In next video, we will discuss about electronic transitions, various type of electronic transitions, orbital diagram, energy difference calculation and crystal field splitting calculation. So thank you so much for watching my videos. please, please subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon for future notifications. Thank you.